Hey YouTube. Anyhow, today is the next part of our repair. Alright, this bit here is the one that was also broken. There was a connection between this bit and the other bit I repaired the other day. Okay, so basically what we need to do is do the same with this one. We bore this out and we just pick up the thread. Okay, it's the same thread as this one. Alright, so 1/4 inch BSP. Okay, and our difficulty today is that when we're holding it, because we've got this ledge here, what I have to do is put a bit of packing in between here and the jaw, just to lift that out so we can clear this. Then with the back here, all I do is just put a plate over here, and that's easy enough done. Then with this bit here, just have to wind the jaw out X amount and just leave it out there. So we can't run this at a high RPM, just the same as the other part. Right now, that's our goal today. We're going to fix that. Okay, this is the plan of attack. Okay, I've got our bit of plate on the back here, so we just don't hold in between in that hole because there's nothing to really grip onto there. Right, we've got our jaw out here holding on the outside one. Right, the only other one that was the problem was this little this hanger here. Basically, I've just got a bit of metal in between here just to pull our jaw out enough so we can grip onto it. So basically, at the moment, we're not running right true yet. As I did the other day, once we get this one in center, we take the readings off this one, then we just put the same readings onto this side here, then it'll run true then. Right, that's my next step, to make it run true. Okay, I've pretty much got it set up in the lathe. Okay, so what I've done is that I've indicated on this edge, that edge, and the back edge here. Alright, so when we turn it on, put it in gear. Right. Okay, as you can see, when they've actually done it, the threads not quite in the center of the outside. But luckily for us, we've got a cheat. All I need to do to in the center of the hole here, it's nice and smooth. So all I need to do is I'll put my indicator inside the hole, we'll center it via that. Then we should be good. Okay, we're ready to go now. I've centered the part on the center hole. Show you it running. Okay, so it's actually centered on the hole. The outside of the hole is wobbling around, but the center part looks not too bad to me. at the moment I'm just trying to find the depth. Once we find our depth, we can actually then continue on from there. Thrilling for y'all, isn't it? But really, a little bit boring. But basically, the idea is we measure it and we just bore out the inside thread root. Basically, what the go is, you, when your screw goes in, so what you want to do is you want to actually get the inside of the actual thread. So, where are we? Basically, where the thread, the bottom of the root of the thread in there, that's basically the size we want to actually make the hole. Once we make the hole that size, then ideally you could possibly pick out the thread, but we'll see what happens. The last one I didn't get a chance to do that, but we'll see what happens with this one. Sometimes you're lucky, other times you're just not. Sometimes what you could do is if you're actually running the lathe in reverse, and if you picked up the centre of the hole, and if you've got some sort of like a left hand tap in there or some sort of way to grip the hole, grip the bolt, as you're turning it, you'd actually want to try and come out itself. Should have brought my glasses over today.
Not much actually in it now. So when it gets to the outer edge of the inner, right, so what we're looking for is we're looking for possibly the like a thread line inside the hole. Let's see if we can. Oops. Sorry about the hand. Okay, what you can see is you can actually see some of the thread on the inside. You can pick it up there. It's on that edge in here. So what we want to do is we want to try and maybe sneak it out a bit more so we can see some more of that thread. The other thing you do is you just go on the edge here and you go to see if you can actually pick away at some of the thread. You could try and collapse it. That's the idea anyway. Yeah, I'll take a bit more off that and we'll keep going. Taking very big cuts, so all we want to do is try and find that start of the thread. That's defined when I turn the lathe off, you'll see. You can see in there now. As I spin that, you'll see the grooves in the actual wall of the hole. That's our thread. Okay, the idea is we've got to try and pick that out. If we can't pick that out, then we have to re-thread that. What I mean re-threading is that you can't actually just put the same thread in there. You would screw the thread up. What you need to do is you need to actually pick up where the thread is. So what you do is with your lead screw and that, and you get your timing right so you can pick up on the actual the internal thread. Otherwise you'd have to probably do the next size up hole, and then again we wouldn't necessarily be able to get that. We'd probably screw that if we don't pick this thread up. Alright, that's what we're doing. We're going to start trying to pick at the thread. If we can't pick at the thread, then I'll try and set the threading tool up to pick up on those threads. Just by hand, I've been winding the chuck while I've got my little threading tool in. Just winding it in to pick up the threads. Anyway, I have, since it's a pretty much a blind hole, I've just been going backwards and forwards with that, increasing the depth each time. So I'll show you. Okay, this is our bit. Screws in. With a bit of thread tape, I'll be alright. I've noticed with this connection is this is parallel, and some of the pipe threads on the actual compressor, they're actually tapered, but this one's just straight. Anyway, that's has a bit of play in there, but I think you'll find the thread tape should actually fix that. And when it seats, it's all right. So I don't have a problem with that. So I'll do that again. Alright, so we make sure we have our gears. 40, can't read that, what does that say? 127 and 40. We make sure our gears on the end here, oops, are those. Okay, now we go. We want number 19 threads per inch, we go C, and we go 3. Then we come down here, go, what's that? Put it on C, and we put it on 3. Then that makes our gearbox 19 threads per inch. Make sure our lead screws on, this with this lever here. Then what we do is we just engage this one. Okay, what we do is we engage this lead screw half nut when our threading dial is on one of these hole numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 3 or 4. What happens with that is that we can actually engage and disengage the half nut when on our lead screw. Each time it comes back and that'll be right. Anyway, so we're pretty much done here now. There you go, our insert's been put in.
Yeah.
So all we need to do now is just need to put some thread tape on it and put it together, and then we'll just put it back on the compressor, then it'll be all done. Give you an update later.